Okay, so do I have more time?
Yep.
Okay, so...
We've got about 5 more minutes.
Okay, good. So you said that atheism leads to nihilism, which means everything's dark, there's no point in living, might as well go kill yourself, right?
That's a street-level definition for nihilism.
Okay, so I think just because there is no ultimate, there is no transcendent meaning, I also see that you can look at atheism as a very liberating thing, where you can go out and live your life however you want to, the way you best, instead of being wasting time, like, what is God's will for my life? I don't know, and I have to ask all these people and pray, and I can't get an answer, and just struggling over that. It's like, wow, I could actually just choose what I want, make my own path.
Well, since
why is that dark?
Since we're talking about natural theology, and which is in the field of philosophy, I just appeal to the greatest atheist philosopher of all time, Nietzsche.
Well, I
and that's why why he was included in the book. Nietzsche consistently, and it's just not because he was melancholy, that things in his life didn't work out, that he was sick and his bones were aching on the Swiss lake.
Let's not talk about certain people. I'm trying to talk to you about atheism, okay? I mean, I could point to some Christian guy and say, look at Benny Hinn, how ridiculous is that's Christianity for you. It's not about Benny Hinn, it's about the ideas, and you're saying...
So why did you mention Benny Hinn and you did last time we were together?
Because I'm...
And before that, you always... Benny Hinn.
Right, well, so I have a whole slide, I'm sorry.
Nietzsche.
I know.
Nietzsche.
I have my couple slides too, but we didn't have time for that. So, my point is, though, why did you...
I'll tell the difference.
Do you think that atheism cannot be positive?
It's not consistent. Let me tell you why. Okay, listen, the difference is Benny Hinn is way out over here.
I don't want to talk about people. No, no.
I know you don't. Okay.
I'm talking about your claim that atheism is depressing.
Well, what I want to say about Nietzsche, who was a real person, and I know you don't want to talk
about real persons,
because you don't want to talk about personality at all.
No, he's not my role model. He's not somebody I look up to.
But he is the atheist philosopher who put forth, and most atheists on the planet are trying to backpedal from this, but he's the one who consistently... He looks at the phenomenon, he infers no morality. He explains to you, go out and live however you want.
Okay, but
that's the magic, that's the brilliant, that's the carrot of atheism.
Nathan, you're answering a different question than what I'm asking. I want to talk about atheism.
It can't be positive.
Why not?
Because
I'm positive. I have a positive outlook and I'm
no,
atheist.
Actually, you're not positive, Bernie. No, you've got a facade. You don't have an inner joy that exudes. You want it so badly, but you thought you could get it in Christianity, and then you went cold on that.
Well, let me
tell you. You don't have the joy and the sparkle that I see in those who belong to Jesus.
I used to have a joy and a sparkle about living forever and having a relationship with Jesus and all that, and now I see it as a delusion, something that's not real.
Right, because you just like
a child could be very happy about believing in Santa Claus and all the presents they're going to get, and then later on they see Santa Claus is not real, they're not going to have that joy about Santa Claus. But they have a different kind of joy because they're being sober and they're living in reality.
Yeah, this world, one place in this book where any atheist, any naturalist reading it would just like glob right on is the argument from evil. Because there we have all sorts of common ground. With our naturalist neighbors and friends, we all agree that this world is dark, that it's full of horrible, cruel, evil things.
It's my turn to ask you questions.
Okay. But
do I still have more time?
I didn't give you a sermon on evil. I was just telling you that's where we agree. And so if you don't have God, Bernie, and you have this dark, evil world, are you really going to whistle?
Well, you have the dark, evil world no matter what.
But I have God, you see.
It doesn't help. I mean, it might make you feel better, but it's not going to cure your cancer if you're diagnosed with cancer.
So you're proving the point that Nietzsche said. Without God, it is hopeless. My bones are aching on the Swiss lake. I should just put an end to this, but you know what? I sort of like being miserable. And by the way, don't you ever give me even one commandment, less 10. And anyone who does that is just a foolish atheist.
Sorry, I didn't really follow that, but anyway.
Well, I thought it was pretty good.